as in the previous class, we have discussed about the importance of political science. As we know, what is a political science? Political science is nothing but it is a study of state and government. That means we are interrelating with the state and government, how they are exercising their rights and duties in order for the development of the society. In the previous class, we have discussed about the scope of political science and the significance of political science. Today, in this class, we are going to discuss about the political science with the other social sciences. As we know, what is a political science? It deals with the state and government, how the state has came into the existence, and what type of responsibilities and the needs of the societies has came into the existence, and how they determined the authority on the basis of the government. What is the government means? Government is nothing but it is an agency through which the will of a nation can be expressed. That means what type of development it needs to the state, it can be fulfilled only by the government. For that purpose, political science played an important role in the modern society. Today we are going to discuss about the political science with the other social sciences. That means what we are doing here, we are analyzing the political science with the relationship with the social, that is other sciences. This process is nothing but it is known as knowledge. That means we are, how the knowledge, the growth of knowledge has came into the existence, how it is developing. We are interrelating the political science with the other sciences. Knowing of this knowledge, as we know, it is unendable. That means it cannot be ended. It will be a process. It is a process of knowing of that. When we are knowing about the social sciences, that means we are learning about the societies and how the culture values were asserted into the society, and how they have been came into the existence, what type of culture was there. All it comes under the social sciences. That means political science, it analyzes us to know about the state and what type of government has came into the existence, and what is the role of other social sciences. When we are knowing about the knowledge, about knowledge can be classified into three types. That is a grouping like the physical science, biological science, and the social sciences. The social science, it is depends and studies about the state and the society, how they have came into the existence, and what type of cultural values and what type of development were there in the past. We are going to discuss in this class the relationship of the political science and the other social sciences. There are many, as I have said, the knowledge is determined into, divided into the three types. That is a sociology, that is a physical science, biological science, and the social science. That is a sociology is there, anthropology is there, and the human geography. That is how the territorial components of human behavior, how they are determining the authority, what type of political ramification it is there into the society. The political science, it deals with the state and government, and we are going to discuss about the relationship of political science and with the other social sciences. Other social sciences like that is a society, that is a sociology, where the political culture, political opinion, and the electoral studies, which it is based on the historical events, the present, the historical is that the past, how they have came into the existence, what was in the olden days, how they have utilized this power, how the empirical basis were there, and what type of political cultures were there, how the tribes and the families, and they have came into the existence, what was the opinion of these families on the politics. It can be known only by the political science. That means we are in this class. In this class, we are going to discuss about the political science and the history, political science and economics, political science and sociology. That means we are discussing about discussing the relationship of political science with the other social sciences. The other social sciences which is needed for the development of political science. Why we need the development of political science? The political science, it enables the citizens to participate into the political activities. As Aristotle has said, who is Aristotle? Aristotle is the father of political science. He has said that the man is a social animal. Why he has said is the man is a social animal in a And apart from that, he has said that man is a political animal also. That means without forming the society, without forming a political institution, all the development cannot be taken into the process. And the Jekyll also, he has said, a definition was given by the R.J. Jekyll, political science is the historical investigation of the state. That means he has said that the political science is the historical investigation. What we are investigating in the past, what it was, in the present, what it needs, and what it is owing to be in the future. That is a study of political science, what the R.J. Jekyll, he has rightly said. That R.J. Jekyll, he is a political scientist. He has given this definition in order to know, in order to study about the state in the past, present, and in the future. Why we are discussing about the past? Because what type of political culture, what type of political opinion were there, and how the political opinion and the culture has to be carried into the future also. This enable us to know about the political science and the other social sciences in order to influence about to know about the development of political science. The first relationship between the political science and history, we are going to discuss about the difference between the political science and the history. Before knowing about these differences, first we know about what is a history. History is nothing but it is a past. That means how the mankind has developed and how they have came into the existence. It can be known only through the history. And when we are talking about the history, we know how the evolution of human beings has came into the existence and what type of cultural values were there, and how they have been associated with the different associations in order to have the development. Thus, records can be get only by the history. And these records, it will be formed into the museums, libraries are there, and the personal collections of the peoples will be there. This history, it provides the base for the study of political science. That means without the history, we cannot know in the past what it was happened and how the implementation, what type of culture was there into the state. When we are talking about our country, India, where there are different type of culture values, how the civilization, different civilization has took place. And how, without knowing about the history, the development of our country India cannot be taken place at present also. That means the political science and the history, they are interconnected. And this history, it provides the reconstruction of man's, that by studying about what the past it was. That means how it enables us to study about the experience of mankind. That means how, what type of cultural values were there, how the religious and economic activities were taken into consideration in the olden days. Everything it comes under the study of history. And this history, it provides the base for the study of political science in order to implement what it was and what it should be in the present society. As rightly they have been said, history without the political science has no fruit. That means without the history, we cannot get the fruits of the political science. And the rightly they have been said that political science without the history has no root. That means without the roots, how the plant will grow? It cannot be grow. If no plants is there, no fruits will get. That means political science and the history, they are interrelated. And without the history, the present cannot be changed. For that purpose, these both are interconnected, and the history, it provides the present society for the reconstruction of man's in the past. That means what type of reconstruction should be there, how they have to be implemented, and what type of constructions should be taken into consideration in order to provide the political rights to the citizens. For example, like when we are learning about the historical events of our country, India, we know that Indian National Movement has taken into the consideration and how the freedom fighters, they have utilized the authority in order to get the equality, liberty, fraternity, all these political concepts, it should be included into the present society. How we are getting this one? Without knowing the knowledge of the history, we cannot get the changes into the present society. For that purpose, history plays an important role. When we are talking about the past, about the other civilizations also. The present, it makes us to change what it happened into the past and what type of implementation should be taken in the consideration. When we are talking about the past in our country India, that how the constitution has came into the existence, by seeing the past of our country India, how the Britishers, they have exploited our country India by draining our economy. All this process, by seeing the past of our country India only, they have made the constitution in such a way that all are equal before the law. That means the equality should be asserted. It can be done only by the study of the history. The historian is only the concentrate only on the past. That means he shows us about the past, what it was happened, and by seeing the past, we can change the present into the society. History, it discusses about the year of the mankind. That means how the evolution of the mankind has came into the existence. But whereas the political science, it deals with the concept and institutions like sovereignty, equality, liberty, freedom. This comes into the existence, and the classification of constitution, different political parties, like this comes under the study of political science. That means political science and history, it plays an important role, and they are interconnected with each other, history and the political science. Without the history, we cannot know about how the evolution of the state has came into the existence, and the evolution of human beings have came into the existence. As we know, without the human beings, those state cannot be exist. Without the human beings, we cannot form the government also. For that purpose, it is necessary for us to know about the past. As the many ideas were given by the Machiavellis also, he has said, the idea of the state, what the state was in the past and in the present, what it wants to be or to be. And Aristotle, as the founder of the political science, he also said that without knowing about the history, the past of the state, we cannot change the present into the state. This comes into the existence only by the study of history. That means history without the political science has no fruit, and whereas a political science without the history has no root also. That means without the history, we will not get the fruits of the political science. Whereas without the political science, the history will have no roots also. Like this, they have been interrelated with the political science and the history. The next interrelation is the history. It is the balance sheet of the activities of the man in the past, and it also includes the political activities also. That means it is like a balance sheet, how we are making the activities of a man in the past, what they have been done, and in the political activities, what they was following, and what is the relationship between the political science and the history in the nature. Then, and how this comes into the existence. As the Professor Silly, he has said that the history without the political science has no fruit. Political science without the history has no root. And the Freeman said that the history is the past politics and the politics is the present history. That means the Freeman, he is a political writer, he has said that the history is the past of politics. That means what it is showing to us, that in the past, what type of political activities were taken into the consideration into the state. But when we are talking about the politics, it shows about the present. That means in the present, it is the history for us. This is the interrelating between the political science and the history. History plays an important role in the development of the present society on the basis of political activities. Without knowing the history, we cannot develop the political activities of a state, and without knowing the history of a state, we cannot take all the political activities or the political concepts cannot be implemented into the state. For that purpose, political science and history plays an important role. They are interconnected between the political science and history. The next, it is a political science and the economics. That means the department of political science and the department of economics. When we are talking about the economics, what is economics means? It deals with the money values. Not only money values, it also deals with the wealth production, distribution and exchange of the goods. That means how to exchange, what the type of production should be there, how the economy of a state has to be increased, and what are the various methods for the accumulating the wealth. And the economic is the sociological study, where we are learning about the wealth production, distribution of the resources. Without the economy, the development of the state cannot be taken into consideration. Why we are saying it like this? Because the economy, it plays an important role for the development of the state, where how to satisfy the unlimited wants with the limited resources. That means it enables us to know if the economy of a state, it is decreasing. In that sense, what will happen? That the citizens cannot participate into the political activities. As the Aristotle, he has said, a good citizens makes a good state. That, why he has said like that? Because the good citizens, the good citizens are there, then the political activities can be developed. But whereas if the citizens are not participating into the political activities, this cannot be developed. When the citizens will participate, when the economic inequalities will be removed into the society, that's the political system, it also influences into the policies of the government. And what type of policies have been implemented by the government, like taxations are there, and what type of production it should be implemented, and how the economy of a state has to be increased, the economic prosperity also, it provides for the success of democracy. What is democracy means? For the people, of the people, and by the people. When the people will participate into the governmental activities, where the economic position will be satisfied. Apart from the basic needs, education and the higher standard of living also, it is required for the development of the state. It enables us to know how this economics and the political science, it plays an important role, where the inequalities which has been given about to the revolutionary changes into the society. When we are talking about the economic inequalities, where in the world, it was for the Second World War, which has taken the consideration for the economic inequalities only. That means if the Third World War would comes into the existence, what will happen? No countries will be existed. That means economic position has to be increased. Economic position, the condition also influence for the political condition of a man. That means it provides economic condition of the man. It provides the man to participate into the political activities. A sound mind, it will have the authority to know about, to analyze themselves, what type of political activities are taken into the consideration, what type of policies have been taken in the consideration by the government, how it should be participating, and how the rights has to be taken into consideration, what type of obligations are there. This everything can be known by the citizens into the state only when the economic position will increase. Without increasing of economic position, the human beings cannot participate into the political science. As they have been opened that by the many scholars, that economic reason is the root cause for the many new political theories, where they have been influenced, and these political theories, they have been influenced in order to increase the economic position, and it also tries to coordinate the methods of satisfying the unlimited wants. That means what type of unlimited wants, and how they have to be influenced, and how they have to be satisfied by the government with the limited resources. It can be studied only by the economic system. That means economic and the political science, they are interrelated. Without increasing of economic position of a citizens, the economic political science cannot be developed. As we have discussed the relationship of political science and the history, and the political science and the economics. That means economics, it deals with the distribution of wealth, resources, production, and how the production has to be increased. And with the increasing of this economy only, the citizens will participate into the political activity. The lastly, it is the political science and the sociology. What is the sociology? Sociology is nothing but it is a science which studies about the society. That means what are the size, type of societies, where all kind of society, where either it is organized or unorganized, whichever it may be. This sociology, it enables to know about what type of, fundamentally, how the sociology, that means how the societies has came into the existence, and how these societies, what type of cultural values has been asserted. It differs from the one state to the one society to the another society, whereas a political science, it deals with the state and the government. And this political science studies about the political organized society. But whereas the sociology studies about all the all kinds of society, whether either it is organized or unorganized. But whereas the political science it studies about the man as a political animal. Whereas the sociology, it is saying that the man is a fundamentally a social animal. For that purpose, Aristotle, he has said that the man is a social and political animal. Why? Because without forming the society, man cannot live. Whereas when the society comes into the existence, has come into existence, the political science also played an important role into the society for the development of the state. Whereas the political science especially deals with the social sciences, because it also studies about the human relation, how they, what type of, which are political the characters has to be played into the society. But whereas the sociology, it deals with the all kinds of forms of social relation in the general way. That means what type of relationship of a man it is there into the society, how they have to be developed, it comes under the sociology. That means the sociology is studies about the society, whereas a political science studies about the state and government. But whereas a sociology studies about the society, all kinds of society, organized or it is unorganized. But whereas a political science, it studies only about the political organized society. Political organized society where their political political science, how it has to be developed, how they have to be approached of political science, and it can be what how they have to be studies. And its own methods of studies, like historical method is there, philosophical method is there, and a comparative method is there. This comes under the study of political science. And the political science is the older science when we are comparing. That means from the history, how the right, how the human beings has came into the existence. But the sociology, it is quite young. Why? Because it has been started from the 2 centuries old only. Whereas the sociology, it deals all kind of organized and unorganized. And the political science is an older science where compared to the other. That means this political science and the sociology plays a cordial relation between the political science and the sociology. Whereas the political science, it discusses with the organized society, and the sociology, it discuss with both organized and unorganized society. And whereas the sociology, it is a wider scope, but whereas the political science, it has a narrower field. Why we are saying it as a narrower field? Because we have to analyze what type of political activities, political concepts has taken the consideration. Whereas Aristotle, he has said that man is a social and a political animal. This is the relationship of political science with history, political science with economy, economics, and political science with the sociology. In the last, we can say that political science has got a great importance among all the other social sciences, where it enables us to know about how the citizens are participating into the political activities. And this social sciences, it enables for the growth of knowledge of political activities, and this can be known only by the political science. And the political science, it enables us to know about the special social sciences, where it shows about the concentrates only on the human relation between the political, that is the state, and the government. That means without the sociology, without knowing the knowledge of the society, without knowing the knowledge of the history, how the state has came into the existence, and without knowing about the economy of a state, the political science cannot be developed. This is the relationship between the political science and the other social sciences. This answer will come for the 5 mark students. Either it may ask for you to explain about the political science and the history. Either it will come for the political science, the relationship between the political science and the economics. Either it comes for the political science and the sociology. Whatever it is seen on the screen, you can note down all the points. It is correct. Thank you.